Assalamu alaikum students, I hope you will be fine. Today we are going to cover multiplication of fractions and division of fractions. Multiplying a fraction by a whole number. When a fraction is multiplied by 1, the result is the same fraction. For example, 3 by 8 multiplied by 1. Dear students, we are actually multiplying this whole number only to the numerator. When we have to multiply a fraction by a whole number, we are actually multiplying the whole number only to the numerator of the fraction. See here, 3 multiplied by 1, 3 ones are 3, and keep the denominator as it is. So 3 by 8 is the answer. Let us understand by solving another example. Dear students, the example is 2 by 3 multiplied by 4. Dear students, when a fraction is multiplied by a different whole number, we are actually multiplying the whole number 4 to the numerator 2. See here, 2 into 4 and keep the denominator same, 3. 2 fours are 8. Denominator same as it is. Yes, students. So this was the multiplication of fraction by a whole number. Dear students, only the numerator of the fraction multiply the whole number and then we get the result. Now dear students, look, this 8 by 3 is an improper fraction. It can be converted into mixed fraction. So we will divide 8 divided by 3. 3 twos are 6. 8 minus 6, 2. Now the mixed fraction is 2 whole 2 by 3. Dear students, this will be the result in the form of mixed fraction. Otherwise, this is the result, 8 by 3. Multiplying a whole number by a fraction. Let's take an example. 4 whole multiplied by 3 by 8 fraction. 3 by 8 is a proper fraction, is a proper fraction. Now, the first step, we write the whole number as a fraction. Dear students, किसी भी whole number को जब हमने fraction बनाना होता है तो हम उसको 4 by 1 कर देते हैं, multiply by 3 by 8. Now multiply the numerators and multiply the denominators. 4 multiply by 3 and 1 multiply by 8. 4 3 is a 12, 8 1 is a 8. Now dear students, look, both are divisible by 4. 4 twos are 8. 4 threes are 12. 3 by 2. Now dear students, look, this fraction is an improper fraction. We can be converted into mixed fraction. Two ones are 2. 3 minus 2, 1. So the answer is 1 whole 1 by 2. Now dear students, we can solve this example by another method. Example is 4 whole multiplied by 3 by 8. First, we write the whole number as a fraction. 4 by 1 multiplied by 3 by 8. Now, we can solve by finding the common numerators and common denominator. So here, 4 and 8 both are divisible by 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So 1 multiplied by 3 and 1 multiplied by 2 in the denominator. 3 by 2. Now this fraction is an improper fraction, so we will divide 3 by 2. 2 1s are 2, 3 minus 2, 1. So the answer is 1 whole 1 by 2. Now multiplying a fraction by a zero. Dear students, when a fraction is multiplied by 0, the result is 0. For example, 2 by 5 multiplied by 0. Dear students, we already know that we are actually multiplying this whole number to only to the numerator and the denominator as it is. So 2 into 0, 2 multiplied by 0, denominator same as it is. Now 2 zeros are 0 and 5. Dear students, when a fraction is multiplied by 0, the result will be the 0. So the answer is 0. Multiplying a fraction by a fraction. To multiply fractions, we follow the given step. Dear students, step 1 is convert mixed fractions into improper fraction. If we have a mixed fraction, first we will convert into improper fraction. Step 2, multiply the numerators of the fractions. Step 3, multiply the denominators of the fractions. Step 4, simplify the fraction to its lowest term. Let's understand by solving the example. Now dear students, this is the example 4 by 5 multiplied by 2 by 5. We multiply the numerators of this fraction, 4 into 2, and we multiply the denominators, 5 into 5. 4 2s are 8, 5 5s are 25. 8 by 25 is an answer. Another example is 14 by 6 multiplied by 12 by 9. Dear students, look, this fraction is an improper fraction. So we can solve by finding a common numerator and a denominator. So
14 multiplied by 12 by 6 multiplied by 9.
Now dear students, look, 6 divides both 6 and 12. 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12. Now 14 multiplied by 2 and 1 multiplied by 9. Now 14 multiplied by 2 is 14 multiplied by 2. 2 4s are 8, 2 1s are 2, 28. 28 by 9. Now this fraction is an improper fraction. We can convert it into mixed fraction. 28 divided by 9. 9 1s are 9. 9 2s are 18, 9 3s are 27. 8 minus 7, 1, 2 minus 2, 0. So the answer is 3 whole 1 by 9. Now the next example is 4 whole 2 by 3 multiplied by 6 whole 4 by 5. Now first step, convert mixed fraction into an improper fraction. So first we multiply the whole number by the denominator and then add the numerator. 4 3s are 12, 12 plus 2, 14, 14 by 3, multiply by 6 5s are 30, 30 plus 4, 34 by 5. Now we will multiply the numerators and denominators. 14 multiplied by 34 and 3 multiplied by 5. Now 34 multiplied by 14 or 14 multiplied by 34. 4 4 is 16, 1 carry. 4 3 is 12 plus 1, 13. 1 4 is 4, 1 3 is 3, 6. 4 plus 3, 7. And 3 plus 1, 4. So 476 by 3 5s are 15. Now we will convert into mixed fraction. 476 divided by 15. 476 divided by 15. When we multiply by 15 by 3, 3 5s are 15, 1 3 1s are 3, 4. 15 3s are 45, 7 minus 5, 2, 4 minus 4, 0, 6. Now 15 1s are 15, 6 minus 5, 1, 2 minus 1, 1. So the answer is 31 whole 11 by 15. Commutative law of multiplication of fractions. The commutative law of multiplication states that the product of two fractions remain the same even if they exchange their position. Dear students, in commutative law of multiplication, the product would be the same even if they change their orders. Let us consider two fractions, 28 by 35 and 15 by 16. To verify the commutative law of multiplication, let's solve this example. Dear students, example is 28 by 35 and 15 by 16. First, we will write 28 by 35 multiplied by 15 by 16 is equal to 15 by 16 multiplied by 28 by 35. Now dear students, look, fractions are same but the orders are different. Here 28 and 35 multiplied by 15 by 16 equal to 15 by 16 multiplied by 28 by 35. Now dear students, look, 28 by 35 both are divisible by 7. 7 5s are 35, 7 4s are 28. Now dear students, look, the numerator 15 and the denominator 5 both are divisible by 5. 5 ones are 5, 5 threes are 15. Now look, numerator 4 and denominator 16 both are divisible by 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 fours are 16. So 1 multiplied by 3 and 1 multiplied by 4. 3 1s are 3, 4 1s are 4. Now the right hand side, 7 4s are 28, 7 5s are 35, 4 1s are 4, 4 4s are 16, 5 1s are 5, 5 3s are 15. Now 3 multiplied by 1 and 4 multiplied by 1, 3 by 4. Now dear students, look, left hand side is equal to right hand side. When both left hand side and right hand side equals, hence the commutative law of multiplication of fractions is verified, because left hand side is equal to right hand side. Associative law of multiplication of fractions. The associative law of multiplication states that regrouping of more than two fractions regrouping of more than two fractions does not change the product. Dear students, in associative law of multiplication, regrouping of two or more fraction, when we regrouping one or more fraction, the result does not change. Let us consider 3/5, 7/9 and 10/21. Let's solve this example. Example is 3/5, 7/9 and 10/21. According to the associative law of multiplication, we solve this example. Now first, we group 3/5, multiply by 7/9, multiply by 10/21 is equal to 3/5 multiply by group 7/9 multiply by 10/21. Now dear students, look, fractions are same but the groups are different. Now 3 and 9 both are divisible by 3. 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. So 1/5 multiply by 7/3 multiply by 10/21. Now 7 ones are 7, 7 threes are 15. Multiply by 10/21. Now dear students, look, 7 and 21 both are divisible by 7. 7 ones are 7, 7 threes are 21. And 10 and 15 both are divisible by 5. 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15. Now 1 multiply by 2 and 3 multiply by 3. 2 1s are 2, 3 3s are 9. This is the left hand side. Now the right hand side, we solve 3/5 as it is, multiply by, now dear students look, 7 and 21 both are divisible by 7. 7 1s are 7, 7 3s are 21. So 1/9 multiply by 10/3. Now 10 ones are 10, 9 threes are 27. Now dear students, look, 3 and 27 both are divisible by 3. 3 ones are 3, 3 nines are 27. And 5 and 10 both are divisible by 5. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10. Now 1 multiplied by 2 and 1 multiply by 9. 1 2s are 2 and 1 1 9s are 9. This is the right hand side. Now dear students, look, in the left hand side the answer is 2/9 and the right hand side the answer is 2/9. That means left hand side is equal to right hand side. Hence, the associative law of multiplication of fraction is verified. Hence, the associative law of multiplication of fraction is verified.